Grace Portolesi, the Executive Director with the Andy Thomas Space Foundation. Thank you very much for joining us again on Australia in Space TV.
Great to be with you, Chris.
Grace, off the back of another successful Australian Space Forum in Adelaide in May, it's amazing how fast time is going. And you're also running Kids in Space, I see there in the background. I've seen some mainstream news coverage for you. Certainly, I think you kicked off in Darwin. And we're gearing up for the next Space Forum in Sydney, first time outside of Australia, outside of Adelaide for the first time. So, yeah, over to you in terms of what you've been up to so far.
Thanks, Chris. Look, there's so much to report. We had a terrifically successful Australian Space Forum in May. Of course, we had lots of international visitors, namely JAXA, and that elevated the entire experience for everyone. So a big thank you to JAXA for participating in that. The foundation made a very important decision to take the second forum of the year. So as you and your viewers would know, the Australian Space Forum is held twice a year here in Adelaide, and ever it has been thus. We've decided, though, given that we are a national foundation, to take the second forum of the year on the road. And so we're starting that this year. And I announced on May that our first stop on the road would be Sydney. And we're doing that in December. So it's exactly the same format. December 5, we will have a dinner the night before, a networking dinner. And they're amazing. The buzz and the excitement of those dinners are fantastic. We will always have a really special guest speaker. At the dinner in May, we had Dr. Hiroshi Yamakawa talk about his own personal and professional experience. I think that was really valuable. And then on the 6th of December, the day after, we will have the forum proper. So it will be held at the ICC at Darling Harbour, which is an amazing venue, and we are building that up, of course. I have a very big announcement to make, hot off the press. We've just had confirmed Dr. Paul Bate, the head of the UK Space Agency, who will be joining us for that forum. So we're very excited about that. We know that these international heads of space agencies are very, very important globally, obviously, but you know, when they come to Australia, it's not just the agency. They bring with them, you know, large delegations, as JAXA did. JAXA brought a delegation of over 20 space organisations. And it's really an opportunity for country to country and business to business collaboration, discussion about opportunities, building bridges, you know.
We'll be celebrating, that'll be the third year, I expect, of the UK-Australia Space Bridge as well. So really starting to bed that down now.
Correct. And, you know, that will feature very heavily as part of that visit. And so we're just working with the UK. We're thinking that this forum will have an AUKUS-inspired theme. So the last forum had a Asia-Pacific sort of regional development theme. But this one will have a bit of an AUKUS approach. Yeah. And so it was great to have Dr. Paul Bate confirmed for that. And it will be very exciting. So for those in Adelaide who had the benefit of never having to travel to participate in the Space Forum, which is fantastic, we look forward to welcoming them to Sydney.
Well, obviously there's a large space industry in New South Wales as well. And I imagine it's a bit easier for Canberra people to get up to Sydney as well. So no doubt, you know, as you say, bringing it to the nation, so to speak, Sydney is a natural place. And in terms of the foundation as well, the Kids in Space, I think that's one way to spread the word about the 16th Space Forum, which will be held in Sydney. Yeah, what's the Kids in Space program looking like?
Look, the Kids in Space program is really what we do at the foundation. So the Kids in Space is an Andy Thomas Space Foundation program. It is sponsored by the Australian Space Agency, and we really value that partnership and that collaboration. And it is delivered by a fantastic South Australian education technology business by the name of Makers Empire. So this program targets primary school age children, and it gives little children their first, usually their first taste of space in the classroom. So we trialled this program here in South Australia probably a couple of years ago now, actually. I've lost track of time, but we trialled it and piloted it here, and it was a hugely successful. What happens is the kids are taught about space in the classroom, so there is a professional development component with teachers. With Makers Empire engages with teachers and thereby starts to create that community of practice. So that happens over two terms. Makers Empire uses 3D printers to teach some design thinking. And then at the end of the two terms, all of these schools that participate and the children come in here to Lot 14, which is the innovation precinct and also home to the Australian Space Agency and the Foundation, and basically have a showcase day. What we've done is, with the support of the Australian Space Agency, we've been able to make that a truly national program. So as we are taking the foundation to a national footing, so are our programs becoming truly national. So we've done, the program's been delivered in Darwin, and you know, I was in Perth a couple of weeks ago, Sydney at Optus headquarters. We had Adelaide last week, and in a couple of weeks we'll be in Canberra and Melbourne. And we'll be wrapping that up, and then we will have a big national showcase day on October 30. You should get down here for it, Chris, because it's absolutely awesome, and it's completely inspiring to see these little kids talk about, you know, creating vacuum cleaners to collect space junk and
nice.
Their plans for how to collect water and grow plants in space. So it's just mind-boggling. You know, when we had funding for about 65 schools, and Makers Empire, who runs the program, put out the expression of interest, and in a period of only 3 weeks we had 500 schools who had expressed interest. So for me, as I keep saying, if the question is STEM, and if STEM is so important to unlocking the future of our nation, and it is, then space is the answer. Kids love space, teachers love space, parents love space, we love it. It's fun, it's engaging, and it's teaching STEM skills. So, yeah.
If anything, it's a bit disappointing. You're only funded for 65 where there's interest for 500. That's a huge gap there.
Look,
and I couldn't agree more in terms of the imagination that kids, that it generates, right, from kids, and it's lifelong for them. How many times did we speak to senior space industry professionals who came in from watching the moon mission in the 60s? So it's just one of those things that just plants that seed for a lifetime.
It really does. You know, when you speak to industry, they're keen to start talking to students in 10, 11 and 12 when they're making those, you know, university choices. But actually, we really want to be talking with young children very early and capturing their imagination as early as we can, because we know that the sky is no longer the limit. And given half a chance, these children are just will blow your mind. Yeah. And so we're very happy that with the sponsorship from the agency and the funding provided by the foundation, that we've been able to make this a national program. We're hopeful that we can continue this program. But yeah, there's absolutely an appetite for this kind of program. It's really, really exciting.
Well done. Look, and absolutely, and I won't undervalue the work that you've done with 65 schools. That's very good. I'm just thinking from a government perspective, federal and state. That should plant a seed with them, particularly to say, as you say, everybody loves space, particularly when you're so young and influential, I think would be the word, able to be influenced in that. And as you say, what was the project with the vacuum cleaners? What was the...
Space junk.
collecting space junk with a vacuum cleaner, is that right?
Yeah, it's incredible. You must come down and cover it, actually. October 30, it's a truly moving experience.
Well, we'll put that in the diary for sure. The other one in the diary is December 5 and December 6 in Sydney for the 16th Australian Space Forum. We will keep up to date with Kids in Space as well, and we'll have some coverage of that in the next edition of the Australian Space Magazine. We're preparing that with you now as well. But Grace Portolesi, we'll keep up to date with any other news coming through. Any other announcements likely as the program develops?
Oh, lots of little surprises along the way, but and you'll be the first to know, Chris.
Oh,
So
beautiful. All
we'll keep you posted. Thanks so
right.
much, as always, for your support.
Wonderful. Grace Portolesi, the Executive Director with the Andy Thomas Space Foundation. Thanks, and lovely to have you back on Australian Space TV.
Thank you.